Assassination attempt on one of the Trumps while in Germany. Look who cops have in custody. The annual G20 summit has just begun in Germany, where President Trump is in attendance, along with his wife Melania, daughter Ivanka, and son-in-law Jared Kushner. While meetings among some of the top world leaders are underway, thousands of out-of-control protesters from across Muslim-riddled Europe have flooded the streets of Hamburg, where important deals are being made among these global leaders. Security certainly has their work cut out for them, especially the detail protecting our first family, who have just taken custody of a suspect who got dangerously close to attempting an assassination on one of the Trumps. Tensions are unreasonably high both in America and abroad by people who have been empowered by politicians masquerading as leaders but are really just perpetuating hate and divisiveness. It's become acceptable for US liberals in office to push the idea of violence for retribution against their candidate, seeking vengeance at all cost. Where assassination used to be an extreme act, attempts have become the norm, accepted as part of what our president and anyone associated with him or supporting him deserves simply for their difference in opinion from those on the left. U.S. senators have been shot at while practicing for a baseball game, one of which is still recovering weeks after the ambush. Citizens flying Trump's MAGA flag have also been hit with bullets for showing their support. At the root of all this is psychotic liberals who are justified in their attempts to kill, all trying to get the winning shot at our president and or his family in a sick game supported by liberals who feel this is par for the course with Trump being president. While the president, first lady, first daughter and her husband are all in Germany, another horrifying try to take one of them out for good was just stopped, this time aimed at Ivanka. Luckily, this deadly degenerate didn't realize that Ivanka wasn't home and was overseas, where she was safer in this case, despite the thousands of protesters who surround her in Hamburg, Germany. The Daily Mail reports, a man wearing a bulletproof vest and armed with two knives was arrested trying to get into Trump Tower. Police say, authorities say Adames Benitez said that he was a US senator and wanted to see President Donald Trump's oldest daughter, Ivanka, when he showed up at Trump Tower around 4 p.m. The New York Post reported, the 52-year-old man who is from the Bronx was also carrying a forged New York stated. Police say, he apparently tried to tell officials that he was trying to speak with Ivanka about her dress line and that he owned the building. While liberals will be quick to excuse this as just an act out of mental illness and not anything to be taken seriously, they are disguising the real terrifying issue. By the encouragement to hate, disrespect, and revolt against our president, they are actually responsible for driving people to commit these atrocious attempts, creating or intensifying mental illness in liberal minions willing and ready to do their dirty work. They support or overlook these acts as to use it against our current leadership to claim his presidency is causing this in citizens, hoping to use it as grounds for an impossible impeachment. Benitez was quickly taken into custody by the NYPD and Secret Service agents. The Daily Mail added, he has been charged with criminal possession of a forged instrument and criminal possession of weapons. Authorities transported Benitez to New York Hospital for a psychiatric examination. Every attack encourages the next, as does the excuses made for these would-be killers who find honor in being a martyr for the liberal cause. Never in this history of our country has there been such deadly discord to our administration and the first family. Thankfully, this effort was thwarted and Ivanka wasn't in New York at the time, but there are more lunatics waiting in the wings, ready to be pushed over the edge into the next attempt. Something must be done about this immediately, which should include stricter punishment for those who attempt to be liberal heroes. We are at war within our own country against lunatics willing to take another's life for simply voting for our president or bearing his last name. With people supporting this resolve, they will drive this country into a civil war before the end of Trump's first term in office.